Hello musicians, my name is Andrew Mercer, and in this short tutorial, I'm going to show you how to add effects to vocal tracks in Audacity. Now, adding effects to vocal tracks is much the same as adding effects to any track. So I'm going to show you that now. It's pretty easy to do. First thing, I've already got a recording here, a very simple recording of me singing Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. Let's check it out. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Okay, you get the idea. So what we're going to do first of all is we're going to duplicate this track. We want to keep the original as is. So we go to Edit, and we go down to Duplicate. Oops, I'm sorry, I don't know if I did that too quickly, but Duplicate is right here. So that's what we want. And that, now we have an exact copy of that original track. I'm going to mute the second track right now, the one we duplicated, by clicking the Mute button right there on the left. Now let's select the first track. As you can see, I'm highlighting the track with my mouse, or I can also click over here on the gray part of the little tab on the left. Either way, and then I go to the effects section, the effects menu, and you'll see here we have quite a few effects to play with. We're going to try echo, so we click the echo, and we have a couple of settings here. We have a time delay, delay time. So let's just put that at 0.2, and we have a delay factor. Let's put that at 0.2 as well and click OK just to see what it sounds like. Now remember, my second track is now muted, so I can't hear the original version, which I haven't changed. The new track, the track one, is changed. Let's have a listen. Twinkle, twinkle, twinkle little star, how I wonder what you are. Now you can see there's a lot of echo there. Let's turn the original track back on and see what difference it makes. Twinkle, twinkle little star, how I wonder what you are. So now you can hear the original is still really strong, but the second one is more in the background. So let's compare again if I just muted that again. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. So you see the effect is in the background, kind of hidden away behind the main vocal track. So this is a trial and error sort of thing. You need to play with this. You may want to raise or lower the volume level or the gain level here on this track or on this track, whichever you like. Okay, you can play with that and see what fits best for your needs. Okay, so let's assume that you didn't like echo and you want to... Oh, I got that changed. Let's assume that you didn't like the echo and you want to get rid of it. Let's just delete that track. Now, we have our original track here still. Let's duplicate that track again, and we'll try one more effect. So you see I got duplicate there on the edit menu. So here we go. I'm going to mute that second track again. I'm going to select my first track, and I'm going to go to effects, and let's have a look at equalization. Now, an equalizer is a way to adjust all of the frequency ranges right across the entire frequency range of a recording. And when I say frequency range, a low frequency is down here and a high frequency is up there, so it's highs to lows. So this, I'm going to flatten that. You can see here we have these sliders here in this graphic equalizer that lets us change how the line looks on it there now, but this is actually changing the sound. So up here at this end is where I have my high ends, the really high frequencies is up here, and if you want to lower them, you bring them down, or you want to boost them, you bring them up, and that will change the sound. Now I'm making all these changes. We can have a listen to see what that sounds like. It's probably not going to sound very good, but let's have a listen. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. And you see, I mean, it doesn't sound that great. It sounds like a tin can. If you make a change you don't like, you just go to undo, and it will erase that change, and you'll go back to your original. Okay, so there you go. I'm going to mention one more thing about equalization. It also comes with a number of presets here that you can try. And if you find a setting that you like yourself that you've made, you can save it. As you can see, the Save As button there. But let's just try one, EMI 78. Let's just try that and see what it gives us.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star.
Completely different. Let's go back to the original and have a listen. This is undo equalization.
Twinkle, twinkle.
See, so it's not as muddy, not as cloudy or dark as the other one. So anyway, you can play with these settings. You can play with the equalizer. You can play with all of the effects in here to try to find the sound that best suits your needs. And again, it's trial and error. Make a few notes too as you're doing this, because you might say, oh, what was that? How did I get that sound that sounded like a tin can? You can't remember? Make a few notes, have a journal going so you can keep track of your effects and what worked for you and what didn't. Now, if this video worked for you, give it a like. And I invite everybody here, if you have any comment or concern or suggestion, please put it in the comments section of this page. And subscribe. If you subscribe, it'll keep track of all the upcoming Audacity videos and tutorials that I'm putting up. So please subscribe. Okay, good luck with it all, and feel free to send me some of your recordings, and maybe we'll have a look to see if you got any questions about your recordings and how they turned out. I might be able to make some suggestions. Anyway, good luck, and I'll see you next time.